Just so you know, my only two core breaker shirts are freshly washed and they are drying right now. Okay?
Don't matter what you look like, don't matter what you wear, how many rings you got on your finger, we don't care, no, we don't care!
Hello my followers to the world of sommelier, this is your guide, Core Breaker. Tonight, my video will be very interesting from the historical perspective. But together it will be the least tasty I ever presented to you. So without further ado, I present you Cahors versus Kagor. You see the difference? So easy to pronounce. Kagor.
This is embarrassing.
Back in the beginning of the 18th century, Russia was ruled by Tsar Peter the Great, famous ruler and a passionate traveler. During his travels in the southern France, he discovered Cahors wine, and because he had a stomach disease, doctors prescribed him to drink that wine exclusively because it was believed that it helps regulate stomach and cardio systems.
If you don't drink wine, I'm not suggesting that you start, but if you do occasionally enjoy a glass of wine, you probably aren't harming yourself and you may be getting a little benefit.
So he brought that wine home, and naturally Orthodox Church chose this wine for their rituals. And church needed lots of it, because comparing to a Christian church, where priests share with the congregation only bread during the ritual, the Orthodox Christians get the holy bread and wine. Back in those times, there were around 50,000 churches, and due to the fact that no grape wine was made in the country, Russian clergy made an exclusive agreement with French winemakers to prepare a deep red, concentrated sweet wine. It was made sweet on the purpose for children to like its original taste and not to spit it during the ritual. After the revolution in 1917, the contract was cancelled.
You're fired.
And Russia decided to make this wine by themselves. There are different technologies of the wine, but I will tell you about Kagor Yuzhnoberezhny, approved even by the Pope. Saperavi grapes with sugar level not lower than 22% must come from Russia or from former USSR republics such as Moldova, Ukraine, Armenia, Bulgaria, and etc. The wine is produced combining heated fermentative juice, 70% wine alcohol, and concentrated grape syrup in proportion 13:1 to 3.5. Wine became so popular that even now older generations who lived in the former USSR still prefer this wine than French Cahors. Let's see what I have. On the French side, I have Chateau de Mercues Grand Vin 2016, and on the Russian side, I have Blagovest Krasnoye Likorskoye Vino by Chernomorsko Zlato. I'll start with the French wine. The Vigoroux family are the pioneers and ambassadors of Cahors wine. Dating back to 1887, German Vigoroux opened his business and started to sell Cahors wine to the northern of the department. After 40 years, his eldest son Gabriel took over the business and lifted up the company by shipping wine in traditional 300 liter barrels. 30 years later, his son George joined the business and adapted it to the bottling sector. In 1971, he decided to give a new life and in the same way show the example to the others by replanting vineyards of Chateau de Haute Serre. In 1980s, he bought Chateau de Mercues, the castle, which dates back to 13th century, looks like from the Disney movies, and has a hotel and a one-star Michelin restaurant. And in 1990s, from the fourth generation, Bertrand Gabriel Vigoroux joined the company and developed the idea of cellar shops highlighting the wines from the southwest of France and its regional product called Atrium. So as you can see, every generation brought something new, developing the family business and spreading the word about Cahors wine. This wine is made from 90% Malbec and 10% Merlot growing on clay silicious soil. Wine is aged for 12 months in oak barrels. And on the Kagor side, I have to admit that for some reasons, I could not find any wine which would have written Kagor on it.
Why yeah, so man. Weak? So weak.
I think it might be some legal issues. I don't know. But this has lots of sugar, 160 grams per liter, lots of alcohol, 60%. It is made in ex-Soviet country and it has a Jesus Christ on its label, so it is pretty close to the original. I have no idea which grape it is made of, because it can be any grape from the Black Sea coast region, and it does not even have a vintage on it, which is even more intriguing.
The less you know, Eugene, the better.
Let's taste them. So Chateau de Mercues has medium plus intensity garnet color with purple hue. On the nose, medium plus intensity aromas of blueberries, blackcurrant, licorice, black chocolate, red currant, and plum jam. Mouth has medium plus acidity, medium plus alcohol, and muscular firm tannins. On the palate, chocolate candies with blackcurrant jam. And Kagor, medium minus intensity cherry color. On the nose, medium intensity aromas of strawberries, cherry, and coffee. Mouth has medium plus acidity, high alcohol, high sugar content, and almost shadowy tannins. On the palate, cherry jam. So for the conclusions, this is just another product together with champagne and cognac, which Russians adapted to their palates. I cannot even compare these two because Mercues is a wine full of potential and great example of high quality Cahors. And this one, this is bad.
Dare you.
Even though it was not expensive, I paid 7 euro and I honestly wanted to drain it in my toilet, but my mom suggested poaching some pears. I would still like to try high quality Pope approved Kagor. Maybe one day in Russia.
Russia. Large, endless and amazing.
Ёб твою мать!
Let me know in the comments. If you tried the Russian version of Kagor, like and subscribe. Salut and na zdorovye!